I know a lot of people out there, though, have that same core pain, have the same issues that they're stuffing, have the same things that they're running from instead of facing.
Yeah.
And it comes out in some other way.
It's the Channel Mom Show with Jenny Dean Schmidt. We're here for you.
Brought to you by Pediatric Dental Group of Colorado, creating positive and rewarding dental visits for kids of all ages since 1977.
Darcy and Danny, both of you during the break were telling me about the core issue. And I have a feeling that's going to be one of your biggest tips today for folks that want to lose weight or maybe are dealing with another addiction. You say you had a food addiction, Danny, and also a gambling addiction. Other folks listening today probably have other addictions that can be helped by your advice. Darcy and Danny, what are you talking about when you say it's not just about the food, it's not just about the calories? What was going on? What did you find out was going on with both of you because you were both struggling with weight?
Completely. I'm doing work with a woman named Tenny McCarty in Buffalo Gap, Texas. She has a 25-year-old addiction recovery center. We're actually forming a television show together that's going to deal with Biggest Loser-style weight loss and with recovery after the fact, because it's not something that just goes away after you lose 250 pounds. And unfortunately, I had to learn that when my father died, and I gained 45 pounds over about a three-month period, and I've got it back off now. But it was a tough struggle with me to figure out that I still had that addiction problem. Though there are things that we have, core pain and core issues that we have, that we may stuff and we may not deal with. And you know what? A lot of times I'm the peace at all cost guy. If it's going to end up in an argument or it's going to end up in some kind of a disagreement, I just let it go. And that's what I think. I let it go. What happens is I don't face the problem or face an issue. I stuff it down into myself. And at some point, it's like a tea kettle. That pressure blows up, keeps building up until it blows. And unless we are able to deal with those core issues, it's going to come out in some other way. If you stuff your feelings and stuff your stuff, it's going to come out somewhere. And with me, it came out in a way that the whole world could see, 460 pounds. And I know a lot of people out there, though, have that same core pain, have the same issues that they're stuffing, have the same things that they're running from instead of facing.
Yeah.
And it comes out in some other way. And maybe it's a verbally abusive relationship with their spouse. Maybe it's financial spending issues. Maybe it's it could be a number of things. Maybe it's alcoholism.
Yeah. Yeah.
We have definitely had to deal with those issues. And when I went to The Biggest Loser, Bob said one thing that was so important. Bob Harper, the trainer there, said, "You have come palms up." And what that meant was I was away from the palm, from the hands up point of resistance.
Yeah.
And I went palms up to where I was at a point to where I was willing to face my issues and walk through the stuff. And when you walk through the stuff, you don't have to be scared of it anymore. You pull it out of the closet, you deal with it, you give it a voice, and then you can live, you can start walking out a path of more health.
And we're going to talk about how this affected your kids and maybe some of the issues that your kids you found out were having in the core that were making them behave a certain way, Danny. But before that, I want to make sure Darcy weighs in on this. I keep using all these puns. I'm so sorry. Darcy weighs in on this. I want people to understand, how do you do that? Because I know there are people out there right now listening who are overweight, who have addictions, who are struggling with something deep down that they don't want to identify. How do you go to that place where you think, before I stop the calories, I need to get to a place where I identify this core issue? What do you do? And what were some of your core issues? Can you share those, Darcy?
One of mine was just like I talked earlier, I was not being real about my life. I attribute that whole time as being in a home with an addict. Now, a food addiction is harder to identify because, we have to have food to survive, right? It's not like alcohol where you can say, you know what, don't drink anymore. Deal with your alcoholism. Go to AA. With food, it's different. So I didn't even see it as addiction. I was living a codependent lifestyle. I was trying to keep everything together because Danny was so out of control. And I was at a place where I could not keep the peace in our home. I could not keep him happy, the kids happy, maintain all of that, and take care of myself at the same time. And so what was happening is I was ignoring it like it was fine and everything was good because I could take care of it all. Like all moms think they can. We can take care of it all.
Yeah.
Bring home the bacon, fry it up in a pan,
yeah.
Do all those things. And it's not possible, to the point where my hair fell out.
Ugh.
And
so something was giving.
Yeah. And
yeah.
So I had just, you know, cried out to God for an answer, and I ended up going to a program in Dallas, Texas, where I was able to walk through some of that pain and that guilt and that shame and deal with it. And Annie and I have recently started a program similar to it called the Journey Training here in Oklahoma in Tulsa.
Okay.
We facilitate people through that, and we give them an opportunity to come into a hotel for a weekend and do the conference with us, and we allow them to walk through the guilt, the pain, the fears, the anger, and all the things that they're ignoring in their life.
And do those things literally make them reach for, this is, doesn't happen to be my battle. You know, we all have different battles. I've got my own.
Yeah.
Can you just explain to me for 1 minute how the core issue makes you eat more or gamble more? Can you just give me an example? Like I have a, you know, fear from my childhood. And so this is what can you give me an example, please?
Sure.
Well, you know, I'll give you an example of my wife, actually.
How nice of you.
Hey, what's he going to say?
No, it's the truth. I think this is the question that you really need answered. And where that core pain sometimes comes from, when she was a young girl in high school, she used to get up and work out early in the morning, mm-hmm. 4 or 5 in the morning as a cheerleader. And her parent one time told her, I have to put on makeup before you go to that workout. And she didn't want to, because she just goes and sweats for 3 hours and it ends up with her hair wet and her face, you know. And what happened was, she was told, you have to put on makeup because you're not pretty enough to go outside the house without makeup on. You need to make yourself up first so you look pretty.
Yeah.
What she heard with that is, I'm not good enough. I'm not pretty enough. Mm-hmm. Well, that pain stuck with her all those years. It ended up in an alcohol issue. And until she walked through that, she couldn't find the healing. With me, it was different issues. I had two older sisters, and I had parents I had a mother that went back to work when I went to school.
Uh-huh.
Now, this may seem little, but you know what? The house we grew up in seems little. Now you go back to the house you grew up in, and it seems little now, but back when we were kids, it was huge.
Yeah, right, right.
Well, the pain's the same way. So.
So what was the pain with your mom? Your mom going back to work?
Yeah, I feel like I'm ignored. I have two older sisters that did everything great and got college scholarships, and every time I went to school, they said, oh, another Cahill, well, you've got to live up to your sisters.
Yeah.
I was so desperate for attention that I wanted people to like me. Well, that has been my competing commitment since day one, and if I stuffed those things, I would end up stuffing them with food.
Huh. Literally, it works like that. Literally, that's what you do.
Yes.
In
some way. Yeah. So Darcy stuffed it with alcohol. She used alcohol to give her a permission to feel and be okay with who she was, because that voice in her head kept saying, you're not good enough, you're not pretty.
Uh-huh.
You're not
and good. Alcohol softened that.
And alcohol softened it.
Yeah.
Food softened it with me. Hey, food never rejected me. They gave me all of its attention, and it made me feel good. And then it turns into a physical addiction in your brain, your cells, and your dopamine runs, and it gets easier. And all of a sudden, you'll think of an egg roll. I would think of an egg roll, and my mouth will water. It's like Pavlov's dog, you know? And that's called an addiction.
Yeah. I want to give people help and to places that you would refer them to your books and so on. But before that, tell me what happened to your kids and all this.
Well, first of all, my son was becoming a very angry boy. He watched his father. His father went outside, and people didn't know that I was struggling. I mean, I'm 460 pounds. I went and talked to my pastor one day and said, I'm thinking about having weight loss surgery. He says, why? I said, well, duh, I'm 460 pounds.
Yeah.
And I asked him why he said that. He said, because I never saw you that big. You were always so happy. I'm like, I wasn't happy. I was miserable.
Uh-huh.
But I played Mr. Happy out there, and I was a great actor. But when I shut the door and came home, I was angry. I once punched a hole in the wall because my wife didn't turn a light off. Now, you talk about crazy.
Yeah.
My son was seeing all this. He was becoming angry. My daughter was seeing all my frustration and stuffing with food, and she started gaining weight. Things started happening in our home that was not healthy.
Yeah.
And that we decided then it needed to change.
Yeah. What is the thing? I mean, I know there are people listening with bated breath. What is the thing that's got to click for them to make them decide to get help?
Well, first of all, they got to realize that there's more with me. It was when my daughter walked in and said she wanted to be just like me. Daddy, I want to be just like you. And I'm 460 pounds sitting on the couch. First, I was thinking how proud I thought, how felt. And then she said, I want a belly just like yours. I had to come to the fact of the matter, being a parent, that there was more at stake than me. I was looking for more life insurance, not for if I died, but for when I died, because I was on death's door. And I was going to leave my wife with no husband, my kids without a father. Same thing with her. If her hair's falling out, she was telling me she wanted to pull a Marie Osmond, which meant just get up and leave and not come back. One time we watched Marie Osmond had a breakdown and left and ended up parked in a desert somewhere because she was having a nervous breakdown. Darcy was there.
For me, what it was that I had to learn that I could not be everyone's source of joy and peace.
Yeah.
That was God's job.
Yes.
Not mine. And I had to surrender to all the emotions that I had and not realize that I had to stuff all those emotions. Anger is a good emotion. It's what we do with it that's bad. And I was just, like I said before, I was codependent. And I hate to use this cliche, but I had to let go and let God.
Yeah,
I had to surrender to the point where God could be God and I didn't have to be him.
Yeah, when you said that, I exhaled because that's such a great feeling. Seriously, it's such a great feeling to do that. Yeah. If you actually can let yourself do it, literally let yourself go in all the best ways.
The day that Darcy, one day I came home and started verbally abusing her like I normally did when the door shut, she turned around and said, you will not talk to me that way, and walked away.
Uh-huh.
I thought my world had ended, but it was like, What just happened? And that was when she said, you will not talk to me this way. She started drawing her boundaries and realizing, I can't help Danny. Only Danny can help Danny.
Yeah.
That's when everything clicked.
Yeah. By the way, I don't identify the two of you and your value with what you weigh, but have you both been basically able to keep the weight off?
We have. It's been a struggle. Like I said, I put on some weight last year, and I'm back on track. And Darcy, you want to talk about that?
Well, I probably struggle a little more than Danny. I went from a 24 to an 8.
Good girl.
And I was feeling great. I maintained that for about a year and a half. Then my parents divorced after 49 years of marriage, and I turned into a child, and I'm now at a 16. So I struggle a little more, but I realize for me personally, where my emotional state goes is I don't deal with how I feel about things. And I tend to run to food or alcohol. I don't drink anymore, but food has become now the more drug of choice. But I do okay.
Yeah.
I'm not a 24, so I keep telling myself that.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Good for you, girl. All right, we've only got less than 2 minutes left.
Yes.
I would like you to introduce a song that we're going to go out with, Danny. We're going to play one of your songs on the way out. Which song would you like us to play?
You know what? Play Second Chance, because everyone needs a second chance. And I think every day is a second chance.
Can we make this our tip for busy moms? Tell moms about how they have a second chance in the next 30 seconds.
Mom?
Yeah.
You know what? For me, it's just the foundation in God and His Word. And His Word says His mercies are new every morning. So I start every day with knowing that I have a God that's able to fill me with His grace and love.
Yeah.
And I just take it one day at a time.
Take it one day at a time, that's right. And Danny, you may have an added word. Make sure you let people know how they get a hold of you so they can get help. We have a minute left.
Yeah, what I would say to that is that the path, God will give you the path, but you got to get up and walk it. That it is you. The second chance is there for you every day, but you've got to stand up and take action. You know, we do the journey training, and everybody's welcome to check that out. The website for that is www.thejourneytraining.com.
Okay.
People can get in touch with me, buy my books, buy my music, email me. I will email you back on my website at www.thedannycahill.com. And I even write a free motivational blog at loseyourquit.com.
Loseyourquit.com.
Quit. Throw it out. Get it out of there.
Awesome. And with that, we say God bless you. Thank you so much, Cahills, for being on the line with us and doing this fabulous interview. I wish you so many good things from God in your future. And we're going to play a little bit of Sound Up, which is so perfect, from Danny's song, Second Chance.
Thank you.